the Squeeze Trigger Report for Tuesday, January 9th. I'm your host, Tom Ronk, founder and CEO of SqueezeTrigger.com. The first thing we're going to talk about today is market direction and see where the Dow and the Nasdaq are going. Then we're going to go over and take a look at OmniTrader and see if we still have our long signals on both the Dow and the Nasdaq. We'll go over to Visual Trader and recap yesterday's trading in 15-minute bars. We'll then go over to the boards and take a look at Squeeze Trigger and see which stocks have short squeezes starting in real time. And we'll also set some alerts for ones that are up and coming. We'll go over and we've got a couple of market history trade ideas to talk about today. Then we'll take a look at Earnings Edge and see which stocks have earnings reports coming out before or after the bell today, as well as those stocks with earnings reports coming out in the rest of January and early February. We'll then go to Seasonal Edge and see which stocks tend to do well from January 9th going forward. We'll look at Commodities Futures and use Commodities Edge to see which stocks tend to do better from January 9th on. We'll look at Currency Edge and see which currency pairs tend to do better from January 9th on. And we'll finish off with Pattern Scan and see, we've got several charts to take a look at. So the Dow opened yesterday with another steady decline, but managed to hold firmly at the 12,350 support level. The OmniTrader chart shows we are still long, but we're fighting to get back above that major trend line that goes back to this summer. The Visual Trader 15-minute chart shows the weak open, then the bounce, and then the bullish run to close back above 12,400 at 12,423. We're still long, and we're going to add to our positions if the Dow gets back above 12,600, and we're going to pull money off the table if the Dow goes and stays below 12,400. The Nasdaq opened yesterday's session with a small decline, but immediately reversed for a slow and steady advance the rest of the day. The OmniTrader chart shows we're still long, but we all are also still below that major trend line, just like the Dow. The Visual Trader 15-minute chart shows yesterday's weak open, then the bounce, and then the slow advance to close up 4 points to 2,438. We're still long, and we're going to add the positions above 2,475, and we're going to take money off the table below 2,390. We have a couple of market history trade ideas on the indexes today. The first one's on the S&P 500. Question: what's happened in the past when, during the first quarter of the year, the Dow Jones, the S&P 500, both end the week down more than 0.5%, while the Nasdaq ends up more than 0.5%? Answer: historically, the tendency has been bullish for the major stock indices. The S&P 500 index shows that, according to the 14 previous occurrences of this event, the SPX has shown a strong bullish edge that peaks 29 trading days after the event. It rallies 79% of the time, that's 11 out of 14 years, by an average of 7.5%. That's substantial. That's relative to the close on the event date. The average of the three declines is only down 1.4%, and the overall return of the 14 cases is 5.6%. The Dow Jones Industrial Average has shown a strong bullish edge that peaks 30 trading days after the event. It rallies 86% of the time, that's 12 of 14 years, by an average of 7.5% relative to the close on the event date. The average of the one decline is down 7.9%, and the overall return of the 14 cases is 6.4%. The Nasdaq shows that, according to the 14 previous occurrences of this event, event edge indicates that the Nasdaq has shown a weak bullish edge that peaks 19 trading days after the event. It rallies 79% of the time, that's 11 out of 14 years, by an average of 6.6% relative to the close on the event date. The average of the three declines is down 6.1%, and the overall return of the 14 cases is 3.9%. So it looks like we have pretty good odds that these indices could all run and hit that 13,000 level on the Dow we were talking about. So let's go over and take a look at our Squeeze Trigger crossover events and Squeeze Trigger alerts for today. Today we have four crossover events and one alert to talk to you about today. I really like the setups today. In fact, I like almost all the crossovers as stocks you could go in and buy. The way that we arrive at these each morning is we go to www.squeezetrigger.com. We click on strategies, we click on squeeze trigger, and up pops this list. The list shows you all stocks crossing up above their squeeze trigger price, okay? We sort that list by total short interest. We only want those stocks with more than 1 million shares of total short interest. So the first one today is one of our favorites. It's Accelus Technologies, A-C-L-S. 4.51 million shares of total short interest. Squeeze trigger price is $6.31. Stock's at $6.37 right now. $29 million needs to cover. We've got a $10 price target on the stock. If you look back in 05, you had anywhere just over $60 million a month being shorted. It ramps up in 06 to over $100 million a month. So we really like this trade today. You might want to make sure it closes over 631, so you might want to wait a little longer in the day. But if it gets up into the high 640s, I think you can pull the trigger. The next one is Heartland Payment Systems, HPY. 2.66 million shares of total short interest. Squeeze trigger price is $24.96. Stock's at $27.64 this morning. $74 million needs to cover. We've got a $34 price target. If you go back into August of 05, where our data starts, it's about $50 million a month being shorted. In 06, it gets up to as much as $60 million a month being shorted. I didn't put Heartland Payment as one of our favorites, but I'm telling you, I like all these today. The next one is 99 cent only stores. The symbol is NDN. 5.55 million shares of total short interest. Squeeze trigger price is $11.70. Stock's at $13.09. $73 million needs to cover. We've got a $17 price target on NDN. Take a look back in 05. You have anywhere up to $90 million a month being shorted. You get into 06, it stays about the same, upwards of about $90 million a month being shorted. So like I said, it's not one of our favorites, but you can buy this one as well. If you've got enough money in your portfolio, I'd spread it across all four of these crossover events today. The last crossover is one of the favorites. It's ENDP, Endopharma. 2.69 million shares of total short interest. Squeeze trigger price is $28.23. Stock's at $30.14. $81 million needs to cover. We've got a $36 price target. If you take a look at back in 05, you had anywhere between $150 and $350 million a month being shorted. You get into 06, it goes up to over $450 million a month being shorted. I really like ENDP because it also shows up later in today's segment as one of our chart patterns. So you got a squeeze trigger, you got a chart pattern, and they just got upgraded. ENDP is a buy right now. The one alert we have today is Luminant Mortgage, LUM. 2.23 million shares of total short interest. Squeeze trigger price is 9.5. Stock's at 940. $21 million needs to cover when it closes over 9.5, which could be as soon as today. $12 price target on LUM. Back in 05, you had up to about $40 million a month being shorted. 06, they've gotten after it here in November, over $60 million a month being shorted. So just keep your eye at 9.5 on LUM. So this is a rare day where I actually like so many of these squeeze triggers as stocks that I would put my money in all of them. Let's take a look at this list for a minute, see which ones you like. I said we like ACLS and ENDP as our tops, but we really like HPY and NDN as well. So take a look at it, and then we'll go to a commercial break.
Tired of losing money in the market? Would you like to know which stocks could be positioned for big gains? Buyins.net has the answer. When traders bet a stock will drop in price, they sell it short. If they bet wrong and the stock rises, they buy it back to cover their losses. It's called a short squeeze and can create a demand for a stock and drive the price higher. Finance.net created Squeeze Trigger to identify short squeezes in real time.
This information was one of Wall Street's most closely guarded secrets until recently, and Binance.net is the only place you can get it. We monitor the market and alert you when your stock crosses its squeeze trigger price. All you have to do is pull the trigger.
You can monitor up to 10 stocks for just $9.95 a month, or for only $19.95 a month, we'll monitor the entire market for you in real time. That's over 15,000 stocks, and alert you to the ones that are crossing their squeeze trigger price. It's that easy. Call 1-800-715-9999 or visit www.buyins.net to unlock the secrets of Wall Street today.
Welcome back. Let's take a look at our market history trade ideas. We only have two today. The first one is Johnson & Johnson. The symbol is J&J. How has J&J performed in the past, omitting repeat occurrences within 10 trading days, when it has seen a big decline after rallying up very big to cross above the upper Bollinger Band the day before? Answer: according to the 12 previous occurrences of this event, event edge indicates that J&J has shown a strong bullish edge that peaks 32 trading days after the event. J&J rallies in all cases, that's 100% of the time, by an average of 6.4% relative to the close on the event date. Not a huge move, but it's not bad either for such a large stock. The next one's Budweiser, the symbol's BUD. How has Bud performed in the past, in the first quarter of the year, when it's gone through a bearish MACD crossover while remaining above the 20-day moving average? Answer: according to the 17 previous occurrences of the event, omitting any repeat occurrences within 100 trading days, Event Edge indicates that BUD has shown a strong bullish edge that peaks 21 trading days after the event. Bud rallies 94% of the time, that's 16 out of 17 occurrences, by an average of 5.7% relative to the close on the event date. The average of the one decline is down 5%, and the overall return in the 17 cases is 5.1%. So let's go over now. We've got quite a few companies that have earnings reports coming out before or after the bell today. I'm only going to focus on 6-quarter edges because I didn't see any 12-quarter edges. So the first one I want to talk about is Volt Information. The symbol is VOL. Their earnings come out before the open today. So go check out right now the earnings on VOL. If the stock's up, you can buy it because it's got a 6-quarter edge and you should see some follow through in it. The next one is Ruby Tuesday. The symbol's RI. This has both a 6-quarter and a January edge. They report after the bell today, so take a look at the earnings after the market. If the stock's up in the after hours, you can buy RI. And then the last one here is Synnex Corp. The symbol's SNX. 6-quarter edge. They report after the bell today. Take a look at it in the after hours. If it's up, you can buy it for some follow through. All right, let's go over and take a look at stocks with earnings coming out later on in January and in February. I'm going to sort it just by 12-quarter edges today because there's so many 6-quarter edges. So KB Homes announces earnings on January 11th. They've got a 12-quarter edge, so we like KBH right here. Satyam Computer Services, SAY, has both a 12-quarter and a 6-quarter edge. We really like that when they line up like that. Earnings come out on January 19th. You can feel free to buy it. Nice Systems, NICE, 12-quarter edge. Earnings come out on February 21st. You can buy NICE here. And Guaranteed Federal, GFED, 12-quarter edge. Earnings come out on January 12th. You can buy it here. Let's go over and take a look at our seasonal edge. We've sorted this by percentage return. We're looking for those stocks that have a tendency to do well from January 9th on. New one at the top of the list is IAAC. It's International Assets. Expected to return almost 36% in the next 14 trading days. It's happened 8 out of the last 9 years. It's an 89% odd. Next one's been up there for several days now, Sirona Dental Systems, SIRO, expected to earn 33% in the next 27 trading days. That's happened 78% of the time. PetMed Express, PETS, expected to earn 27% over the next 26 trading days. It's happened 9 out of the past 9 years. And Allscripts, MDRX, expected to earn 26.8% over the next 29 trading days. That's happened 100% of the time in the past. We're going to look at the flip side of this, stocks that have seasonal weakness here from January 9th on. Internet Capital Group, ICGE, is new at the top of the list, expected to lose almost 20% in the next 31 trading days, happens 86% of the time. Internet Network Services, INAP, expected to lose 18.5% over the next 21 trading days. Happened 7 out of the past 7 years. MIVA, M-I-V-A, expected to lose nearly 17% over the next 21 trading days. That's happened 100% of the time. And Charter Communications, CHTR, expected to lose just under 16% over the next 18 trading days. That's happened 86% of the time. So let's go over and take a look at commodities. We still like live cattle futures here, expected to earn 3.23% over the next 30 trading days. That's happened 22 out of the past 30 years, or 73% of the time. Zinc is expected to do well over the next 10 trading days, earning just under 3% with a 74% likelihood. Take a look at the NASDAQ 100 stock futures. 100% chance over the next day that it's expected to earn 1.96%. So take a look. We might have a big run here anytime now on the NASDAQ. And on the flip side of those, European currency is supposed to be down almost 2%. It's happened 88% of the time over the next 26 trading days. And natural gas futures, it looks like they're almost done here, expected to only be down 1.88% over the next trading day, happens 75% of the time. So let's go over and take a look at our currency pairs. The first one here is finished markup per the US dollar. That means you take a look at the ticker symbol. Whichever currency is first is the one that is that you're trading. So when you see the 1.91%, the US dollar is supposed to firm against the finished markup. 71% likelihood over the next 22 trading days. The dollar is supposed to get strong against the Russian ruble over the next day, but the likelihood, the odds aren't good enough. They're only 67%. Greek drachmas, the dollar is supposed to get stronger against the drachma over the next 22 trading days by 1.75%. That's happened 86% of the time. Down on the bottom, the euro is supposed to get strong against the Indian rupee. And, well, let's take a look at this. The EUR INR is expected to drop 2.07%. And over the next 22 trading days, that's happened 9 out of 10 years. So that basically means that the euro is going to get weak against the rupee. And the US dollar, per the Irish punt, when you look at this, it's the IEP is first. So it means that the Irish punt is going to drop 1.94% against the dollar. So let's take a look now at our pattern scans, and there's a lot of sell signals here. This makes me nervous. So the first one is a New York Stock Exchange short term. The symbol's LNT, Alliant Energy. It's one of the oil index stocks. It's a short term trade. It's a swing trade. It was a sell the other day. It got reiterated today. Sell LNT. The next one is a long signal. It's Endo Pharmaceutical, ENDP. It's a NASDAQ short-term trade. It's a swing trade. Was a buy yesterday on a move up to 28.85, and it just got reiterated to buy. The next one is also a short-term NASDAQ trade. It's a sell. TTM Technology, sell TTMI. It's a swing trade. It was a sell up around $12, but it just got reiterated. It broke down below support. Steer clear of TTMI. Another sell here. It's a pattern scan. New York Stock Exchange long-term trade. Symbol's TOT. It's an ADR. It's a breakout below the trend line. Ugly chart here. Steer clear of TOT. Same thing here on Dress Barn. We mentioned it the other day. It's a NASDAQ short-term trade. It's a pattern scan. It's a swing trade. DBRM broke down below the trend line, and it's just been reiterated sell again. Now, here's another one. Sell Amazon, AMZN. We were long Amazon for a short squeeze. It went from 38 to 42. We were up 4 points. It's reversed now. You got to get out of AMZN. It's broken down below the trend line. It's a long-term pattern scan. So this could be a long-term change in Amazon stock price here. Same thing on Netflix, NFLX, same pattern. Pattern scan, NASDAQ, long-term, broke down below the trend line. Was a sell with a reiterate sell, steer clear of Netflix. Another one, NASDAQ long-term, same pattern, sell HAIM. We mentioned this the other day. It's broken down below the trend line, and it is a sell with a reiterate sell on HAIM. And we'll end the day on another sell note here, sell MANH, Manhattan Associates. Same pattern, that's 4 in a row, broke down below the trend line, and with a brand new sell signal with a reiterate the next day. So the market is telling us something here. We've been petering out here around this 12,400 level. Now, there's the seasonal tendency for the market to do well is still keeping us in the market. We feel like the market can make a run, but it's right at that teeter-totter edge here where we could have a 100-point down day and it's going to start washing out people and people are going to start selling and it'll get worse. So we need a good 100-point up day on the Dow this week. Get back up above 12,575, up above 12,600 and make a run for that 13,000, or we're going to be stuck in the mud here for the next week or a couple of months. So check in with us here tomorrow. You can tune in at 1 p.m. Eastern or 10 a.m. Pacific at mm1.com to see us live. We also instantly archive the show at SqueezeTrigger.com. You can go to YouTube. It streams real quickly on YouTube. Just search for Squeeze Trigger. If you have any questions, email me at tom@SqueezeTrigger.com. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll talk to you tomorrow.